Morning, everyone. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello, hello. Thank you all so much for being here with us. Last call to find your seats if you've not done so yet. Thank you so much for starting your Wednesday morning with us. I believe that all of you ordered up this gorgeous weather, so I'll give you all credit for that. So thank you, thank you. My name is Kyla Woods, and I'm delighted to welcome you to the official kickoff of the River Roots Experience. Let's give it up for River Roots. And we want to start with a special thank you to Woody Keon, President and Chief Operating Officer of the National Underground Railroad Freedom Center, for hosting us today. Please, let's thank the Freedom Center for hosting us. We are gathered here this morning to announce America's River Roots, a music, culinary, and cultural experience set to take place on October 9th through 12th of 2025. This will kick off America's 250th birthday in 2026. So let's start now with messages from our very own co-chairs.
The Ohio River has such a rich history. It played a pivotal role in shaping our country's growth and diverse cultures. It was the destination of tens of thousands of freedom seekers that crossed the River Jordan in Cincinnati and many locations upriver and traveled then along the Underground Railroad throughout Ohio. The Ohio River was also the major transportation corridor that fueled the western expansion of our nation, with settlers and products shipped on flatboats and steamboats to all points on America's inland waterways. We are proud to showcase our unique Ohio River Valley heritage to the world. And the American 250 Ohio Commission has endorsed America's River Roots as a signature event for the state.
The Iroquois word Ohio, or the Great River, became the name of the state of Ohio and the river that separates the Commonwealth of Kentucky and Ohio. For centuries, the mighty Ohio River has been used to transport goods and food, to create energy, and for recreation and leisure. The growth of our nation was forged by the people and industries along this river. Team Kentucky is happy to celebrate our common heritage with our neighbors from Ohio. We are working hard to build bridges, not borders. In fact, we've got a very special bridge we are building together in the very near future. And this region will co-host America's River Roots in October 2025 to kick off our nation's 250th birthday in 2026. Team Kentucky is really excited about this event and celebrating America's birthday.
Our nation's 250th birthday presents a perfect opportunity to promote the cultural tourism assets of our region. For example, the Freedom Journey, with stops in historic river towns originating at the Freedom Center right in downtown Cincinnati. Distiller tastings at River Roots and the Keeneland Fall Meet, and of course the Bourbon Trail. UNESCO World Heritage Earthwork Sites, or the National Park Service Water Trail to extend visitor stays at River Roots. As an avid Ohio history buff, I think it's our time to tell our story of what makes the Ohio River region, with its verdant hills and valleys, a special place in America.
All right. We are so honored to have our three very special honorary co-chairs. And of course, we're honored as well to have our wonderful mayor here with us, Mayor Aftab Purval, our energetic leader who understands how signature events like the River Roots Experience will continue to build our region's brand. Please welcome Mayor Aftab.
Good morning, Cincinnati. Thank you all so much for being here today. It's really an exciting announcement. Celebrating not only our city, our cultural heritage, but also our incredible country. I'm so proud to join leaders from the region as we look ahead to such a special opportunity to lift up our entire Cincinnati history. This is the ideal location to celebrate America's river roots. We have a world-class riverfront park system, second to none, designed for world-class national events. And with roots music on both sides of our river, river boats going in and out, and great multicultural food throughout the venues, this can be something that everyone can enjoy and take pride in. I'm sure I speak for my colleagues across the river, Covington Mayor Joe Meyer and Newport Mayor Tom Tom Gadooly, when I say that city leaders live for opportunities to showcase our communities, to welcome regional and national visitors, invite area residents to come out and enjoy unique programming like this. River Roots has the potential to bring so many new eyes and dollars to our region's beauty, our river heritage, and the common roots that have so made us so strong for so many generations. I am so excited to bring the nation and world's eyes towards the Ohio River, towards our region, not just because of the celebration of our past, but because we are moving so quickly and so aggressively into the future. In fact, it will be Cincinnati and the incredible leaders and special companies and incredible people here that will define the future of our country. Thank you all so much.
All right, thank you, Mayor Aftab. And from one energetic leader to another, it's also an honor to welcome our Hamilton County Commission President, Alicia Reese, to the stage. She has always been an advocate for investing in events and attractions that draw visitors to our incredible region, and as Mayor Aftab said, dollars. We want to bring those to the region as well, while simultaneously continuing to create a sustainable economic impact. Please welcome Commission President, Alicia Reese.
Thank you, Mayor, for saying the hard names, so I don't have to do that. Let me just say, Kelly and Rick, when you guys first came to me and presented this idea, I think it's been a year, and I want to just say a lot has happened, and I want to congratulate you and the committee on the work that you've done in that year to be able to bring us today for this huge announcement. I had some written talking points, but on my way here, I've got, you know, when you have to go to the dentist and you're not feeling too great. I was calling my dentist when I was on my way here, Deaver Dental, and trying to get an appointment. And they said, that's great and dandy, even though I'm in pain, right? They said, but are they bringing tall stacks back? Like, what? And Jenny, the office manager, got into that conversation that I still don't have an appointment. No, they're working on an appointment. But the fact that she said that her grandmother, she said, Jenny said, I didn't have a lot of money, but my grandmother would take me down to Tall Stacks, and that I still have my passport. And I was exposed to Tall Stacks and the Ohio River in a way that I had never been exposed as a little girl. And so when we talk about river roots, I think the word roots is so important because there are roots. We're not just coming up with this because we do have a great birthday to celebrate, but because we've had a long-standing history here in bringing people together and celebrating on the Ohio River. And so I'm excited to be here today for this announcement. All of the investment that we have made, whether it's the Freedom Center, we've got two ballpark stadiums, restaurants, and everything in between, hotels, and now a Cincinnati Black Music Walk of Fame. I'm very excited for us to be able to celebrate the music and the heritage at the same time. So we're very excited to be a part of this. The Cincinnati Black Music Walk of Fame is celebrating our first year anniversary on July 27th. We'll be able to talk about getting people who are coming in town to get ready to come back for the Roots celebration. And we just tie it all in. When I was at the state, I was Deputy Director of Tourism, so that's why I know, and Julie and I have worked together for many years, and I know the importance of tourism being economic development. It's not just talk for me. I've actually pitched conventions, pitched events, and when you think about the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame on the lakefront, and then you have now the Cincinnati Black Music Walk of Fame on the Ohio Riverfront, and then all the music that connected us in between, that's what we're going to be able to celebrate with River Roots. So it'll have it'll be a great time, but it'll be what I call edutainment. We get a chance to be educated and entertained at the same time, and we can do it on the water with everyone who has those fantastic boats. A lot of people here are partners, have been partners with us, and we look forward to extending that partnership. You got Sturkey here, who is the official chef for the Cincinnati Black Music Walk of Fame and River Roots, so we'll be able to bring the food and the culinary together. Kathy Wade, I think in a few minutes you'll be hearing from her. They have all our accolades, except one thing we're missing. Kathy Wade is in the Cincinnati Black Music Walk of Fame, so people can learn about her and enjoy. So we'll be able to bring the augmented technology along with the River Roots. And if you haven't gone to the Cincinnati Black Music Walk of Fame, when you leave here, go across the street and go right down 20 minutes. You'll be able to perform with Bootsy Collins and Penny Ford. And I'm just excited that we'll be able to have that now with River Roots and be able to come together. So this is excitement, and I don't think anyone will have this in the country. And we will be able to have this in the country with River Roots tying with the technology of the Cincinnati Black Music Walk of Fame. And I see Blink is here. We did a big piece here, and we'll be doing it again with them as well. So we're on the move, Hamilton County. I'm super excited, and I can't wait to have all these. I get to tell everybody, bring your boats. Come on now. Come on down here. Don't go to Miami. Come on down here. We've got it. So very excited. It's a party with a purpose, and we're excited to be a part. I see Anastasia there. She's taking notes about how many writers she can bring in town to write about all these great things. Thank you for all of your work, and thank you everyone who is here that cares about moving our county forward. So let's go, River Roots.
A step's a doozy if you don't watch it, so got to make sure she gets down okay. Yes. Thank you so much, Commission President Reese. And unfortunately, Kathy Wade couldn't be with us today. She did have a bit of an emergency arise, or she would have been here with us. But you will hear more about her very unique and significant contribution to River Roots later on in the program. So we're sad that she couldn't be here, but we will make sure that she is recognized as a part of being a part of River Roots. All right, so now I'd like to announce the title sponsor of River Roots, First Financial Bank. They were the first. You see what I did there? You see what we did? Okay, thank you. Thank you, Archie. They were the first to invest in the event and see the impact for our region. Please welcome Archie Brown, CEO of First Financial Bank.
Thank you, Kyla. When First Financial was presented with the opportunity to become the title sponsor of America's River Roots, there was no hesitation. We're all in on this event. It's just going to be an incredible, I think, incredible long weekend of activities. First Financial's mission is to be a positive influence and to help our clients and communities thrive. We truly are committed to the communities in which we live and work. That's why it made perfect sense to get behind America's River Roots. This 4-day event will be a celebration of all that is unique about our region, our culture, the extraordinary cuisine that sets us apart, and the talent that has produced our region's rich musical heritage. Most importantly, America's River Roots will be one of the first events nationally to celebrate America's 250th birthday. Last year, First Financial celebrated its 160th birthday, having received the nation's 56th National Bank Charter in 1863. Since then, we've proudly served families and businesses of this region, growing with you and watching our community transition from rafts and riverboats to the economic powerhouse we are today. This event will be something we can all be proud of, and that's why First Financial is honored to be the title sponsor of America's River Roots. We look forward to celebrating our river heritage with our friends and neighbors and with thousands of visitors in 2025. Thank you.
Thank you again, Archie. And together with these additional event presenters and many other area companies, along with local and state government partners, we will present America's River Roots, a celebration of music, cuisine, and culture. And now we have a quick preview of the excitement you can expect with this very unique experience. First up, Cincinnati native Bryce Dessner, a vital and rare force in new music. He's won Grammy Awards as a classical composer and with the band The National. He's also a founding member of The National, and he will curate nationally known artists in all of the roots genres featured on multiple stages throughout the riverfront. The National will perform a special tribute to roots music at the event. And to our Kathy Wade, a Cincinnati treasure, two-time regional Emmy Award-winning jazz performer and co-founder of Learning Through Art, is producing Sounds of the River. This is a highly interactive educational program tracing the historical flow and cultural sounds wrapped in waves of stories along the Ohio River, from the first drum beat in Africa to spirituals, gospel, blues, jazz, bluegrass, country music, and a calling from the Mississippi Delta. Food, of course, tells the story of the culture of a region. Paul Sturkey, who's had a few shout-outs so far, will be our famous hometown chef and product development chef at Kroger, and he's inviting celebrity chefs to present the cuisine of the river regions of America. Under his direction, small business enterprises, food trucks, restaurants, and caterers will also be recruited to enhance the quality and variety of offerings at our event. All the pure water from the streams in Kentucky that Governor Beshear and his team were referring to flows into the mighty Ohio, but beforehand, it makes a mighty fine distilled spirit that has made our region famous worldwide. You may know what I'm referring to. Amy Tobin and company will be recruiting emerging distillers for bourbon tastings at the event and organizing with Julie Kirkpatrick of Meet NKY. The Keeneland Bourbon Trail travel packages will also be promoting to international bourbon club members. In addition, Ohio Brewmaster Tastings and Cincinnati's historic brewing tours in over the Rhine will also be featured. Riverboat cruises on 12 riverboats from America's inland river cities have accepted our invitation to participate in this historic celebration. Captain Alan Bernstein, a member of the National Waterway Hall of Fame, is coordinating the logistics working on the theme for riverboats with the food and music of our region. A River Cities Expo Pavilion will also showcase their cultural tourism attractions at this historic event. The Purple People Bridge will become good and rooted local market with food artisans of prepackaged products and cultural artisans showcasing a variety of regionally made products for sampling and purchasing recruited by Rachel DeRocher and her team. And Lori will manage the beverage concession and vendor operations on both sides of the river. Other projects in the works include a River Roots Gospel Revival, which I am particularly excited about. I love gospel music. Produced by Eric Rigaud and social media clips to educate our audiences. As Commission President Reese mentioned, this is an opportunity for education and entertainment, or edutainment, which I love. And so we will have that to educate our audiences about Ohio's musical legacy, originating from King Records, produced by Yemi Oyedirin. And a digital platform for telling the freedom journey in Uptown Rivers and animating the historic Riverwalk sites along our three-city riverfront that will be available for cultural tours. Visit Cincy and Meet NKY are collaborating to promote the River Roots to regional and national audiences with the goal of driving event attendance and extending those visitor stays through national tours. Cincinnati region will tell the story of our Ohio River region. Cincinnati experience will tell the story of our Ohio River region, its unique assets, and our historic contribution to America's first 250 years, and we will share that with the world. The Game Day Communications team will direct the media relations and social media management. And at this time, I'd like to ask members of the planning team to please stand and be recognized. Been working very hard. And now I'd like to invite Elizabeth Pierce, CEO of the Cincinnati Museum Center and board member of the America's 250th Ohio Commission, to the stage.
Hello. You can see everybody has a role here, and mine is to be the official history nerd of the group. So when Kelly and Rick came to me and asked if Woody and I would participate as the history partners, we said, this is a great opportunity to connect with the America 250 Commission. And I'm very pleased to have Todd Kleisman here, the executive director of America 250 Ohio, to help us explore that. So we're very excited to have America River Roots as one of the kickoff, the signature event to really launch Ohio's exploration of our 250th plus experience here. So thank you for being here to celebrate that. So I want to ask all the executive committee members to stand for a round of applause, and then I'm going to have Rick and Kelly come forward and tell us more.
Thanks, Elizabeth. This has been an amazing civic-led volunteer effort. The last year, all the people in this room that have stepped forward to come up with these concepts, these professionals that curated the event elements, to our advisors who took the leadership to step out and take on this big vision. And we're really looking forward to working with our partners like Cincinnati Parks, Jason Behrens here, the City of Cincinnati, City of Covington, and Newport to plan the logistics of this event. It's going to take everybody's efforts to pull this off, and we know how to do that. I also wanted to recognize some public officials that are here today. Denise Driehaus, Commissioner Driehaus, who encouraged us to pursue this idea several years ago. I don't know if she's still here. Also, we have some council members. Anna Albee is here. And Mayor Joe Meyer from Covington is here. Anybody else that we miss? Oh, we have also Pavan Parrish, the county clerk of Hamilton County. So thank you for showing your support by coming here today. We will be following up with you to seek your financial support. So everyone gets to participate. Also, one shout out to Tom Kempton and Carolyn Swabek, who's been helping us with the sponsor and foundation fundraising. We really appreciate your efforts. And then Karen Dime for planning this great event. Thank you, Karen. Finally, I want to thank Archie Brown and the First Financial Bank team. Like I said, they were first, and we appreciate them stepping forward, along with our event presenters, Western Southern, Cintas, Alta Fiber, Kroger, TQL, and 1NKY. Your commitment to the vitality of the region is amazing. Thank you. Now I'd like to also recognize Kelly, the co-founder of River Roots. She's quietly volunteered her company's services for the last year as well. So thank you so much for your leadership. So today, this is just the launch. There'll be many opportunities for other companies, individuals, arts institutions, civic organizations to get involved. This is going to be a massive community engagement, and we look forward to everyone's involvement. Thank you.
All right, thank you all again so much for being here with us to celebrate this launch. I'd also like to give a special thank you to our local media who's here covering this event. We will get national recognition for this, but I also want to thank our hometown media for sharing this story with our community. So thank you all for being here. We appreciate you, and thank everyone for coming. Please have a great rest of your day. More announcements to come about America's River Roots. Thank you.